Power BI also supports some more unusual visualizations like funnel charts or waterfall charts. Let's take a look at waterfalls. I'm going to insert one, and again I get the template visual here. And I only get two options here, the category and the y-axis. Now, waterfalls are typically used to show changes in a particular value over time. So for our category, I'm going to drag year to show changes each year. And I'm going to use our year-to-date variance. So here's my waterfall chart. If you've not seen one of these before, what we're doing is for each year, in this case, we're showing how a value has changed. So in this case, the year-to-date variance. So firstly, there was an increase, and each year, the variance was only a little bit higher each year until 2007, when they actually had a negative variance to date in their total sales. That continued for a few years, then there were a few years where it is increasing again, down to the current total of 132 million. So it's a great way of tracking these changes over time. I can continue to slice and filter this as with any other visual. And in terms of formatting, I've got a few different options. The axis formatting again, data labels on and off, and I can control the colors that are used to show increase, decrease, or totals. So if I want my total just to be gray, I can make those sort of changes. So waterfalls are a really simple way of tracking changes to data over time. Funnel charts, on the other hand, are typically used to show changes over a particular process. So if you're using if you have perhaps a sales pipeline, or you're looking at retention rates through a website, funnel charts support that sort of thing really, really well. We're also adding new visualizations all the time to Power BI. There'll be new ones coming out over the course of months and years as we update the service. And as we'll talk about later on, there are also ways that you can create your own custom visualizations if even these more esoteric ones don't fit your exact needs.